COVID is such a challenging time, and the communities are facing many complex challenges. The very first thing we did was just reach out to all our communities and go, who's open? Who's not open? Who's at risk because they don't have protection for their staff? And so in the early stages of the pandemic, a lot of it was just reaching out, talking to everybody and going, how can we help and how can we direct either funding and or other resources to those agencies so they could be responsive and reopen and serve the most vulnerable in the communities. And obviously we've got growing homeless populations in most of our island communities. And so one of the key things we wanted to do was to keep COVID out of the homeless population, because we knew that would be a super spreader. You know, that would make for problems for everybody, and we wanted to keep that vulnerable population safe. Just since March, we've been funding 126 organizations and 164 programs through our region. We know food security is an issue. We've had some of the food banks close down. We had to step in and figure out how to get donors' dollars to get food delivered in some of these more remote communities. You know, many people have been laid off. And so what we're seeing is families actually facing food insecurity for the first time. The mental health issue, vulnerable seniors, the teens, and young adults is certainly a big area that we're seeing a great need for mental health supports. We know we're seeing from point in time counts that United Way does in March, we're seeing an increase of absolute homelessness. What I'd like our donors to really understand is we're trying to move upstream to prevent people from being homeless. So if we can do rent supports, if we can help people prior to them becoming absolute homeless and having to go into shelters, that's key. Our real concern right now is we've been responsive both with the federal dollars and with our donor dollars this fall, but if we don't run a strong campaign this fall, many of those programs aren't going to be available next year.
Ladysmith was very much a mix of food security and loneliness. So we had a lot of senior citizens and families at home alone. So we were able to fund a local service provider to take food and visiting out to senior citizens and families. Just last week, I had an update, an anecdotal that was amazing around a senior citizen that was lonely at home and had reached out and were carving pumpkins for this organization to just drive around and share. You know, the difference that made in the lives of those seniors is monumental.
The need is huge in our communities through next year. Turning to our donors again this fall, saying, if you can, please give. It's going to be needed more than ever.